dealing with the law of exponents. And in this one, we're going to ask, what exponent can we raise a number to get a square root? Now we know that the square root times the square root of a number is equal to the number. And we know that any number can be written as that number to the first power, to the power of 1. So we're looking for some power to raise a number to, and we multiply by itself to get that number to the first power. Now if we use this formula here, where a to the m times a to the n, we just add the two exponents. Well, in our case, m and n are both the same number. We're using p in this case. So a to the p, which is going to be the square root of a, times the square root of a, is equal to a to the p plus p. P plus p is 2p. So a to the 2p is equal to a to the 1. So we have this equation here, a to the 2p is equal to a to the 1. And this leads us to the equation that 2p equals 1, because we have some number to the p power, the same number to the first power, so 2p must equal 1. And this is a fairly simple equation to solve. P is equal to 1/2, which means the square root of a is equal to a to the 1/2 power. Now, we're wondering, what does a number to a certain power means that you multiply it by itself that many times. Well, what does it mean to multiply a number by itself 1/2 a time? Well, that takes a bit of imagination to figure out, but if you go back and look, and you see that we've actually divided up the multiplications of a . Each of these is 1/2 of a multiplication of a. It might take a bit of imagination to sort that one out, but it does work. So trust me, and use this whenever you do need it. And we can further go and find out what formula to use for other roots of a, like the cube root of a or the fourth root of a. This n in the crook of the root symbol means we can put any number there. If it's a square root, that would be a 2, but usually we leave that understood that that's a 2 or a square root. But if we want, say, the fifth root, the number we multiply by itself 5 times to get the number, that would be the fifth root of a, and written as an exponent, that is a to the 1 over 5. And in more general terms, we have that the nth root of a is equal to a to 1 over n.